glorified and that the world will come to know who he is.
Contagious. It's this song is full of passion, and I pray that it will start a revival. The Church of Jesus Christ is in need of a revival. So we need to be refilled with the Holy Ghost and fire so that those who don't know Jesus will come to know him, and those of us who do will begin to spread the love of God and the fire of God everywhere we go.
Says when the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled the whole house where they were sitting. Verse 4, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. Just like he did it before. How many know we need him to do it again? All right, here we go. Just like you did it before, Lord, we are ready for more. Just like you did it before, Lord, we are ready for more. Just like
you did it before,
Lord, we
are ready for more.
Just like
you did it before,
Lord, we
are ready for more.
Just like
God is faithful, and Never Lost is such a powerful song with a powerful message. The first time I heard it, I knew it was something that everyone needed to hear. It was during the time when the pandemic had just reached over here to the United States, and I don't know, we just felt a sense of hopelessness. We felt like we were up against something that we couldn't get over, that we couldn't pass through. And it's a good time to be reminded that the God that we serve has never lost, and He never will. He has all power. Nothing takes Him by surprise. And He has come through for me time and time again. I heard something the other day, and I thought it was so profound. It said, we only doubt God when we forget about what He's already done. We serve a God that cannot lose. He's never lost, and He never will.
Miracles when you move, such an easy thing for you to do. Your hand is moving right now. You are still showing up at the tomb of every Lazarus. Your voice is calling me out. And right now, I know you're able. And my God, come through again. You can do all things. You can do all things. But then, 'cause you never lost the battle. No, you never lost the battle. Bible says in John 1 and 5 that the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not understand it or overpower. What does that mean? God is so powerful. It doesn't matter what trial you find yourself in. It doesn't matter how big the mountain is. He's greater. And it's not even close. He's so much greater. And he has all power. He knows the end from the beginning. So you don't have to be afraid. Actually, you can rejoice before you see your prayer answered. Don't have to wait till the battle's over. I can shout now. I don't have to wait till the battle's over. I can shout now. I don't have to wait till. Come on, sing that with us. I can shout now. Oh, Lord. Don't have to wait till the battle's over. Why? Cause we've already won. Why? Cause he's already won. Hey, yeah. Don't have to wait. I can shout now. I can shout now. I don't have to wait.
It is a powerful song, and I pray that everyone who hears it will release their faith for the impossible. Why? Because we serve a God who specializes in the impossible. I remember being in the hospital, and my brother Ronald was on the operating table, and the doctors came in and said, "We lost Ronald." And my father said, "Well, can we pray for you and you go back in and give it another try?" And the doctor looked at us and said, "Hey, if you want to." And we all began to pray. My father laid hands on the doctor and he went back into the operating room. And the next thing we heard, Ronald was in recovery. So we lost him, but the God that specializes in the impossible brought him back. And so if God can raise the dead, he can handle anything that you're going through. Anything that you've been through, he can handle what you're facing right now, and he knows what's happening in the future. So you can release your faith and believe. He responds to our faith. God responds to our faith. So don't be nervous. Believe, and God will show up and do what only he can do.
They say this mountain can't be moved. They say these chains will never break. But they don't know you like we do. There is power in your name. We've heard that there is no way. Moving, immovable.
2020 was a rough year for everybody, and I know a lot of people are hurting. A lot of people lost loved ones. A lot of people lost their income. A lot of people are dealing with illnesses and sicknesses, and God is saying, don't give up. Don't give in. Just keep believing. Why? Because he's going to show up. He's never too late. He doesn't always come when we want him to come, but he's always on time. The God we serve is faithful, and he will come through for you, but you gotta keep believing.
You said, I believe. You said, it is done. You said, I believe. You said, it is done. Can you help me sing?
You said,
Alabaster Box is probably one of the most powerful songs I've ever heard, and definitely one of the most powerful songs I've ever sang. This song is about a woman who was forgiven much, so she loved much. And you know, a lot of times people think that because of what they've done in their past, that they've been disqualified, but that's not true. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you so much that he gave his life, you know? And if you just believe in him, his love will wash away your past. He said, the Bible says that if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. old things are passed away, and behold, all things become new. And so this woman with her alabaster box recognized Jesus and was so grateful for the love of God that she knew he deserved her best. So she washed his feet with her tears and dried them with her hair. And she washed his feet with this incredible, expensive perfume. And really, this is a picture of worship. When we worship God, you want to give him all of your heart. And Jesus told us that we would remember her. Why? Because of her worship. So I want to encourage everybody who's watching, worship Jesus because he loves you so much that he deserves nothing less than your best.
The room grew still as she made her way to Jesus. She stumbled through the tears that made her She felt such pain. Some spoke in anger, heard folks whisper, "There's no place here for her kind." Still on she came, through the shame that flushed her face, until at last she knelt before his feet. And though she spoke no words, everything she said was heard. As she poured her love for the master from her box of alabaster, "So I've come to pour my praise on him like oil from Mary's alabaster box. So don't be angry if I wash his feet with my tears and I dry them with my hair. 'Cause you weren't there the night you did not feel what I felt when he wrapped his loving arms around me. And you don't know the cost, not of this oil in my alabaster box. No one knows what you've been through. I can't forget the way life used to be, 'cause I was a prisoner to the sin that had me bound. And I spend my days, I pour my life without measure into a little treasure box I thought I found.
You were there.
You know, I was blessed to be raised in the church. And I fell in love with Jesus at a really, really young age. I'm gonna try to get through this without crying. And I got to know him personally. And all I can say is that he has made all the difference in my life. When Jesus shows up, everything changes. If you're hopeless, he gives you hope. If you're down, he lifts you up. And he gives you life. He is a life giver. So I always tell people it's not about religion, it's about a relationship. When you ask Jesus into your heart and you allow him to be the Lord of your life, then he's going to change your life and he'll give you abundant life. And I love it because his love never ends. It's eternal life, you know? So I tell anybody, I tell everybody, I don't care who you are, where you come from. If you say yes to Jesus, it will be the best decision you have ever made and the best one you will ever make for the rest of your life. I guarantee you that.
Jesus, bright as the morning star. Jesus, how can I tell you how beautiful you are to me? Jesus, song that
let's worship him. Let's love on him.
Hallelujah. Everybody sing Jesus.
Bright as the morning star.
Jesus.
How can I tell you how beautiful?
Jesus, you're beautiful.
When people see this program, I want them to experience a revelation that God loves them. People are hurting. The pandemic, our economy, our nation, we are in need of healing. We're in need of hope. And I know that the love of God is strong enough to restore and renew, and not just make us the way we were before, but make us better than what we've ever been. So I pray that when they tune in, they will receive the hope that they need, that they will receive the joy that they need, but most of all, that they would receive Jesus.
Sweeter than springtime, you're purer than sunshine. Ever my song will be.
You know, with so much negativity going on, it's easy to focus in on what's wrong, what we want to see changed. But it's just as easy to look up and remember how good God is. His love is everlasting, and He's faithful. He's a faithful God. So when you focus in on who God is and what He's already done, all of a sudden, your heart begins to fill up with gratitude, and now you can be positive, and you can see further than the negativity. You don't even want to be a part of it, you know? So when you focus in on God, He's full of love, He's full of peace, He still has all the answers, then all of a sudden, negativity kind of just disappears. God is good. He's faithful, and you can stand on that. You can believe in that. And if you just wait on Him, He said, if you wait on Me, those who wait on the Lord, He will renew your strength. So you might feel like, I'm ready to give up. I can't take this. Just hold on. Keep waiting on Him. Why? Because He's faithful. All my life, He's been faithful. All my life, He's been good. It doesn't mean you're not going to have a bad day here and there, but it does mean that He will never leave you, He will never forsake you, and whatever you face, He's going to pull you through.
I love You, Lord, for Your mercy never fails me. All my days, I've been held in Your hand. From the moment that I wake, till I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life You have been faithful, and all my life You have been so, so of the goodness of God. I love Your voice. You have led me through the fire. In darkest night, You are close like no other. I've known You as a father. I've known You as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life You have been faithful.
Oh, yes, You have.
And all my life You have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, of the goodness of God.
The name of Jesus is more powerful than any name. He has all power. He has all wisdom. Nothing takes him by surprise. There's no one greater. And when you recognize who he is and you begin to lift up his name and you lift up your head, you begin to see over every mountain. You begin to see a way of escape. You know, so he's hope to the hopeless. He gives peace to those who are in need of it. He by his stripes we're healed. Everything we need is in him. There's no greater joy. There's no greater peace. I could sing and praise God all day long. I can dance forever because his joy never ends. There's nothing that compares. The Bible says, in the presence of the Lord, there's fullness of joy. There's no greater high. No amount of money, no amount of fame can come close to the greatness of God. Just look at the universe. He created everything, you know? And so there's no one greater. And if we as believers really believe that, we don't get a chance to say he's great today and then tomorrow we're wondering if he's great or if I'm gonna. If he's great, then just let him be great. You know, he's paid the price. And as we continue to see him for who he is, we're going to live in victory. We're going to experience the joy of the Lord, not some of the time, all the time. The peace of God that surpasses all understanding. The love of God that's strong enough to reach way down and lift you all the way up where you belong. The greatness of God never runs out, and it's second to none.
I've celebrated, sweet drink I've tasted, they come and go.
I'm excited about sharing all of these incredible songs because I know that it's going to be a blessing to everyone who gets a chance to see it. But I just want to say thank you to those who have taken out time to watch it. And I just want to encourage everybody to open up your heart and receive, because God has something special just for you. He really does. So get involved, clap your hands, and let's worship God together.
If it's greater,
then
let him be greater.